Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's compare two free ways for you to do speech to text on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you by a community of more than 350 supporters. Find out how you could become a part of it at MacMost.com/Patreon. So a lot of people ask me how they can dictate to their Mac. There is a way built into macOS to allow you to dictate, and some people are looking for something better. Now there used to be some software that was really popular that did it, but that's kind of been discontinued. So people are looking for other methods. So using the built-in macOS functionality is great, and that's the way I do it. But some people look for another solution. And there is another one. It's using Google Docs. Using the free service from Google, you can dictate into a word processing document. Now the pros and cons to both. So to use macOS's built-in functionality, you want to go to System Preferences, and then you want to go to Keyboard, Dictation, and make sure the dictation is turned on and you have Enhanced Dictation checked. Then you can check your keyboard shortcut to see which one you're using. And that's the basics. But you also can go into Accessibility and from there look for Dictation on the left. And here is where you can access dictation commands. Because it's not all just about saying the words. You need to be able to do things like select words and change styles and things like that. So you can look through all the different commands that you can speak while in dictation and it will use it to alter the text. So let's give it a test by going into Pages here and I'll use the FN key twice to start dictation and we'll give it a go. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. This seems to work pretty well, period. Plus with enhanced dictation, comma, you can type at the same time to combine the best of both worlds. Period. So you can see there it worked pretty well, but it didn't get everything right. It messed up a little bit there. I was talking a little bit too fast. I find if I slow down a little bit, then it usually works better. So the other option is to use Google Docs. Google Docs is a free service from Google. If you've got a Google account or a Gmail account, you can go and log in and go to docs.google.com and create a document there. And then there's a feature there called voice typing. So the most important thing to remember here is you have to use Chrome. You cannot use another browser because the functionality to take the audio from your microphone and then use it in the doc, that is built into Chrome, so you're not going to get that with Safari or Firefox. And you just go to docs.google.com. That's how you get in there. And I'm going to start a new word processing document. So this is the word processor. Some of you may already use it. Now you go to Tools and there's Voice Typing and you see Command Shift S is the shortcut. And when you select that, it brings up a little control here and I can click it to speak or I can use that keyboard shortcut. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. This also works pretty well, period. It seems to be getting all the words without much trouble. Exclamation point. And I clicked again to stop it. Now there are also commands associated with this. They are built in. There's a document here, a support document that gives you a list of all of these. And you can see here there's tons of voice commands for selecting text, formatting, editing, all sorts of things. You can do similar things with the built-in macOS functionality, but it seems that it's a little bit more robust here with Google. If you're just going to write a word processing document and you don't mind using Google Docs instead of, say, Pages or TextEdit or something else, then I think using voice typing is the clear winner. However, if you want to be able to use dictation anywhere, you know, in messages, in emails, typing in forms on Safari, then of course you really need to go with the built-in functionality because this is only going to work if you're inside of Google Docs. Another advantage to using the built-in functionality in macOS is that you're already signed up for it, right? You don't have to get anything additional. With Google, of course, you have to do the Google account, you have to sign into it, you have to be using Google Docs, and you have to be working in Chrome, which is probably not as optimal, especially if you're on a MacBook as using Safari. Another advantage to using macOS is you can customize the voice commands. You can actually add new ones. So when you say something, you can do all sorts of things in different applications. You can even run automator workflows, all sorts of stuff. So it's highly customizable. So I think there are advantages to both. I would encourage you, since they're free, to try them both and see which one works better for you. But if they seem to be more or less the same, then probably go with built-in macOS dictation.